Hey, Teddy. What's going on, bud?
Nigga, what area are we in?
Donald Trump, if you can hear us, please, Donald Trump, please save me. Please save me, Donald Trump. Please.
You tell her that she has breeding hips. Breeding hips to a 13-year-old. What does that mean?
She wouldn't have a problem having a baby.
You like what you see, then take it.
If you like what you see, you take it. Like what you see,
you talk about a glory hole. Wanting the boy to go to your house.
God. Welcome to war mode.
Well, listen, Boobski.
Oh, God. Never mind. I can't take it.
You fucking kidding me?
Oh, my bad.
Oh. Can you bless me with something?
Oh, gosh.
Money wars. Please.
Can you suck it?
What?
So why would you? Come on, bro. We got the video.
We have the video.
You like getting punched in your nuts?
I'm going on a cruise, you know?
Get the popcorn popping, get the sodas pouring.
Two. You said it's a 13-year-old, correct?
No. Yes, but no. That was probably not honestly me, sir. Like I say, my brother does use my own phone, too.
Just please tell me what I need to do, man.
What I do is just inject some of my into her. And then I use magic to grow the embryo over time, and then the embryo takes on a new...
Oh, my bad.
Jerry.
What?
I'm Chris Hansen.
I know who you are.
God, I really want to be friends with you.
Oh, because I've said I would never do this, and I did it
anyway. I can't believe
anyway.
I'm talking to a 14-year-old girl who sounds fucking hot. I hope I'm not too dirty to you.
A full-blooded elf is a rare and powerful creature indeed. Treat them with respect, should you ever come upon one.
He said it is what it is. Well, it is what it is because he is who he is. That's why it is what it is.
Lahaina strong. Stay strong, my brothers and sisters. And all of you billionaire vultures coming in, you better step the hell off. Oprah, Bezos, step off.
That's all I'm saying. It's like it was like clapping bricks, but yeah, as loud as gunshots.
Dude.
And then I went outside and walked around, and I could not figure out what was going on. Nobody reacted to any sound. No lights went on. No cops ever came. I was outside for about 5 minutes at like 3 a.m. in my underwear.
And yeah, and whitey tighties is a rogue ass fucking move. If someone were to drive down the street and see you like that, they could think someone escaped the insane asylum.
Yeah.
The asylum
is like right down the street.
Just from thinking about it, I think it could have been a dream. It may have been sleep paralysis, or the way these cars are backfiring like the Hellcats and the shit on track mode, it could have fucking got you. Or someone literally just lit off a firework, but it is weird that no one was outside. But
that fucked me up. And then last night I had music playing, so I didn't sleep again. And then I fucking got all geared up to show you the photo album, montage I made, and I didn't realize there's actual video tour of the Freemason Temple. So feel free to watch that whenever you have time.
Yeah, I mean, after COVID, there's like fucking,
I'm like showing you the pictures, you're like, oh, cool, man. And I'm like, dude, I mean, this is fucking secret knowledge. And I open up YouTube, it's like pages of it. So
yeah, it's what they allow you to fucking walk it and see.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah. I feel for you on the fucking sleeping shit, though, because there's been so many times, especially with sleep paralysis, dude, where, like, if I get sleep paralysis at 3 o'clock, I'm up for the rest. Like, I don't fall asleep until, like, I just fall asleep because of tired.
Yeah.
Like, I'm up until, like, 5 o'clock, and then I finally will go back to sleep.
Yeah, I tried to overcompensate it with all that coffee, and then I got whacked out. And then the next night, it was a combination of, I was sitting there, like, you know when you're freaking out because you can't sleep?
Yes.
And then I was remembering that I drank all that coffee. So I was like, oh, I will fall asleep. This is fine.
It called you a little bit.
And, but then the music started blasting. And then I was like, oh, I'm never going to sleep now.
I mean, someone might just be fucking...
I'm a T.I. I told you this.
You literally might be a targeted individual.
Me and Patrick Byrne, we're T.I.s.
Dude, it's that Patrick Byrne story, like... It's
fucked up that that's not a TV show.
It makes me want to jump back into the fucking pool of opium because, like, they're going to come up with something. They have to come up with something. Yeah. To get like, I think I'm on, you can't get me at this point with the fucking Q shit, but I know they're working
on
something.
He's pre-Q though.
I know that, but I'm saying for this next election cycle, like, I know they're working on something. Like, there's dudes like us who, like, we went through Q, fell for that shit for a little while, then slowly started realizing it wasn't real. They're going to come out with something that gets me and you going to the point where, like, we freak the fuck out on it. But like, at this point, you have to, like, give me something that I can hold on to.
You're talking about a white hat scenario.
Just some sort of, like...
I mean, what the guy puts... it could be completely fabricated. What is the thing called? Whatever.
That magazine. Capital Time magazine.
Whatever that is. He could be on a fucking schizo fever dream coming up with this thing. But the stats he's pulling out with the Maricopa County, and he's all over that Carrie Lake shit, so...
Dude.
It's like the voter fraud is fucking wild, bro.
That's like...
His whole thing is like you only need these six counties in the swing states to win an election. So you don't really have to do this massive fucking thing. And you remember when Biden had that clip? He had that gaffe when he's just like, we have the biggest voter fraud
Time. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. So Philly, Phoenix, Georgia, all these places just shut down. They were like, oh, we can't pipe burst. We can't count the votes.
Yeah.
And they just stopped counting in the middle of it. Who the fuck knows, dude? The country might already be gone.
That's like, I've just chalked it up to that because, like, watching it, it's so obvious that they stole that shit. And then you're going, like, it's that demoralization shit he's telling you where it's like, I don't even want to go off about fucking Trump because it's literally just like, I was driving this morning, like, dude, am I at the same level as the people who are putting back on the masks? Like, if I walk around like, dude, Trump is about to eat their lunch with this getting locked up shit. Like, I was, like, driving down the road, like, dude, I think I might just be on the opposite side of the spectrum of thinking Trump's going to pull this one off.
I don't know. I mean, that dude, he's got some cool shit in here. It was kind of like the Garrett Ziegler thing when he's talking about they got Hunter Biden talking to the Iranians about how they had $8 billion in frozen assets in South Korea.
Yeah, $800 million.
No, $8
billion. What?
They had $8 billion. And Hunter was like, if you write a check to the Bidens for $800 million, we'll unfreeze that for you.
Holy fuck.
And he was making a deal for nukes. He was doing all that shit.
I mean, that's not that far-fetched because that's what he was doing in fucking Syria or wherever the fuck. Or where was that? Syria?
Yeah, he was doing it in all those countries in the Marco Polo.
He was trying to Libya. He was trying to unfreeze Gaddafi's fucking assets.
Yeah, but the Dolphin Speakers, the League of Shadows, the OS-07 secret agents... The patriotic transsexual hacktivists, the blue leaguers, the pajama Hadeen from back in the message board days, like
all of this shit.
This is the best shit. This is some of the best. Like, and I was telling you, like, all I read is nonfiction just to fucking like learn shit.
Yeah.
And then to read this is like a TV show. This is like a movie. This should have been a movie.
I mean, I wouldn't mind like at this point if like people come up to you like, dude, like you getting into that's fucking stupid. Like you have to know it's fake. And I'm just like, the dude's like, dude, I know wrestling's fake.
Yeah.
This is just the funny stuff to watch right now because.
Like this dude sitting here saying that the real plan, their plan, the deep state's plan, was Brennan took over the FBI with the CIA. They were going to run. Hillary was going to be president for 8 years, but really it was going to be Obama's third term.
Yes.
Obama's going to be president for 24 years. That's in that. This dude's sitting there straight face saying this shit.
Dude.
So, I mean, it might, like, they had a thing called Operation Snow Globe, allegedly. Could be fake.
It could have. Everything sound too good from when I was listening to it.
Just shake the Clintons up. I mean, when I was cracking up watching that Trump-Tucker, because when he said the Bushies.
Yeah, obviously.
Like, just to call the Clinton-Bush crime family the Bushies, dude.
The dude is the fucking king of juice, dude.
The Sanctus.
Yeah, but, like, him talking about that, like, it makes sense that, like, it no matter, like, whoever's, like, running the CIA who, like, literally runs everyone, has all the dirt on anyone, they're obviously going to fucking blackmail whatever president they can and just cause a shitstorm for them if they go against their cause.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, I read all those things about the Hawaii thing with, like, BlackRock owning all that, and BlackRock owns, like, 35% of, like, the world's fucking... currencies or whatever. I don't know. They have all
assets.
They have all
it's
those
40-something percent of the world's assets.
Yeah, so they're not sitting on all that U.S. gold, but they're doing this kind of stuff. So they can just go take over swatches of land in the world.
When I was listening to that,
dude, this guy. Sorry.
Go ahead.
That guy, Patrick Byrne, he's sitting there going like he's talking about how these insiders, they're getting killed, but they're telling Barr, they're telling Patrick Byrne like there's going to be a world war.
Yes.
This is the start of a new war. The Iranians are telling Patrick Byrne himself. So Soleimani is telling Patrick Byrne, there's going to be another world war. And this is how they're going to kick it off.
Yeah.
And then they kill Soleimani.
Yes.
And Patrick has cancer.
obvious. Like,
fucking wild. This, and he's banging the hottest chick on the planet.
Yeah,
a literal superhuman. I love that part.
Yeah.
Back in the saddle, baby.
If you just took the SNZ part of that whole story out, I would probably be like, dude, it's happening again. Yeah. But like, once that dude was like going off about like how he not only had a girlfriend, but she was actually a genius and also a genius power lifter. Like,
who knows? I mean, if you're an FBI asset or whatever, an asset of whatever, and who knows? There's probably like three-letter agencies we don't even know about. Yeah. But if this dude's being used as a disinformation agent or he's just having a good time with it,
obviously,
who the fuck knows? He's making $500 a head at these events.
Dude's smart enough to get Overstock.com going. So like,
and he was running shiesties on them.
Yeah, I mean,
he was doing all kinds of weird trading shit that he learned from Buffett.
Dude,
when he was hitting me with, he was raised Catholic. He majored in Catholicism, modern in Jew.
Yeah,
and then he's sitting there going, "We had a rabbi relationship with fucking
Warren Buffett."
And then when he claims that he put together the meeting that I think, do you remember the guy Patrick Berge?
Yes,
he put together a meeting allegedly, I think, with the Kraken, Patrick Berge, Trump. I can't remember all these people, but you know, it's Rudy.
What
and this was all like to see what they're going to do about the recount.
Yes.
And like, he allegedly put this fucking thing together. And when he says it in the book, he says he yented it.
I know. He uses interesting vocabulary for shit like that. It is like, he was around when all that, like Mike Lindell was walking out of the White House with the weird pamphlet, a weird book, and no one knew what the fuck it says.
Well, he does these events, this Reawaken America thing. He does the events with the pillow guy.
Are they a part of the symposium?
What's that?
Mike Lindell symposium.
I don't know what that is.
He runs symposiums for like, dude, don't you remember this stuff? He had like,
hey man, I forget a lot.
When the election fraud stuff was going on, Mike Lindell was like the god of breaking this shit out. And they started having fucking symposiums, and he would like, it would be like a 4-hour long fucking symposium that was just nothing. Like, nothing would come out of it. They would just say,
just like get togethers.
Yeah, but like, they were like, we're going to blow the lid off fucking election fraud on this. And it never happens.
Well, yeah, on his Telegram, he's like, you got to wait for a secret attack. And when you find one, like a Pearl Harbor, you must commit.
Obviously.
And that this article is what it is.
We have them lined up.
99 pages, great read.
It is.
I would classify it as fiction, and, you know.
Until, like, he could be telling the truth. And there's some shit that, like, you can kind of back up. He's not wrong about the tranny hacktivists.
Yeah, right.
Like, all this shit
that
does
blew my mind when you start talking about I called them the League of Shadows. They had my back. They were looking out for me.
Yeah, he kind of reminded me of like a Stephen Kelly type that was just like, dude, I got people looking out for me. Because like, usually if you know this much shit, you're literally just getting fucking killed.
But he is one of the Bitcoiners, and he's got a blockchain that allegedly they're all afraid of, the system.
Yes.
So
And they're
on another white hat thing that
they're the ultimate school shooters. Like, anytime you fucking do it, it's like, I have a dead man switch, you have no idea what I'm capable of.
They're
you just have like 5 Bitcoin in a wallet.
They're betting the house on white hats, solving the financial market.
Did it once, not doing it again, dude. I fucking bet the house on white hats. I literally sat there while the entire world got locked down. I'm like, no, this has to happen to us. The last time I went with a this has to happen to us is 2 weeks to slow the curve, because I thought they were going in to deep underground military bases, which is fucking crazy, because when you sent me that list of shit, everyone forgets, like, dude, I wasn't, like, we weren't freaking out about mole kids and shit like that.
What,
like,
list? Oh, the list.
Of shit, like, we weren't freaking out about mole kids on a whim. Like, there was articles coming out that they were doing underground, like, city warfare and tunnel warfare. It was on, like, military.com.
Yeah, well, that's the thing that fucked me up, because when I was watching all that stuff about the Troubles, the British did this. So they would psyop the fucking Irish into not knowing what's going on.
I don't know what's going on.
It's called the 77th. Yeah, it's called the 77th Brigade, and they would just run these psyops. And out of that brigade is where you find out about the Kinkora sexual abuse. And, like, real shit comes out of it.
What's the Kinkora sexual abuse?
It was a boys' home where these guys that were, like, the leaders, of, like, they were in, like, the higher-ups on the Protestant side of that war.
Yeah.
The one guy was kind of like a prepper. Kind of like a Boy Scout, and he was running an orphanage, and Lord Mountbatten was going and visiting it.
Oh, yeah, he told me that.
And fucking, it all came out in the wash in the 80s, but they sent this one dude to jail. There's a documentary about it called The Man Who Knew Too Much, and it's a pretty fun watch, but I mean.
It is, like, the disinfo.
They, yeah, they, what I was going to say was they had the sophisticated PSYOPs. They were running PSYOPs. So, like, as soon as that shit kicked off in 69, that was what they did. They sent in the royal fucking PSYOPs.
I know.
And Obama did that Smith-Munn Act where it, yeah. they
You reminded me. There's so much shit. Like, that list has shown me how much I forgot in 2 years, let alone 2016 until now.
Yeah, so they, like, reorganized whatever the fuck protections we had against propaganda. And, I mean, allegedly Obama also fucking did this thing where you can recount if you're the president, you don't like the results.
If they're a sign of election meddling, yeah.
Yeah, so, but when they redid that, you can use propaganda on Americans, but, like, I think most people just think that's commercials.
Yeah.
You know, like, they don't realize, like, it's fucking... When they want to play games with you, dude, no one will know what's going on.
Well, dude, like, that is the shit with Hawaii right now. Like, when I was looking at it.
I like that shit you're saying with the fucking, the blue houses.
Dude, it's like that, it came out and it was on, like, the first thing that it comes out on is, like, a Flat Earth Society Twitter. And it's like, oh, these are all the houses that are painted blue. But, like, dude, this is the shit where, like, that propaganda stuff.
Well, hey, man, I'm not, like, I don't want to fucking interrupt you, but. Do you remember the Flat Earth Society? They yes. had meetings and shit?
Yes.
I don't think they do it anymore. I think that was like the first round of this stuff where they like kicked it off. Dude. Obama said it, which was fucking very weird.
Yes.
And then they had like a whole convention in Florida.
Out of
and
all
you know what's fucking weird is
too.
Patrick Byrne lives in Sarasota, Florida, which is where the CIA was training those hijackers.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, so at this point, I see this fucking Maui shit happen or Lanai, wherever the fuck it is. And I see that thing. Blue houses didn't get burned the fuck down. And I'm like, damn, that's fucking crazy. And I start looking and it's like, well, it's fact checked. Obviously, those houses are doctored and those aren't Hawaii and shit like that. But then I see the fact check and I'm like, well, you lied about COVID. So I have no fucking clue who the fuck is telling the truth or not.
Yeah, I mean, if the journos are fried, they're gone.
Nick Sortor is fucking going in by himself. Like, that's the only fucking dude. And they hate on him because he didn't go. If you got to go to college for journalism, dude, you're a douche.
Yeah, I mean, Patrick Byrne said they're the dumbest people at college.
Nick Sortor. And that's the other thing. Like, you watch the dude, Nick Sortor. He's going in there. He's screaming at the mayor about where are the fucking kids. The mayor does not want to answer it. Like, a lot of fucking people got iced. I'm never putting numbers on anything anymore. I'm just going like based off what I can see and what is definitely true. The dude's a fucking weirdo. Like that mayor seems like a fucking asshole. Like the dude who's like actually Hawaiian.
The guy that's like the water sacred.
Is it green? Is that the mayor?
I have not been following it like you.
Yeah, he's like, he's just a fucking weird ass dude. And like, they're all way too fucking paid. Like the mayor's a absolute strange bird. And when people are interviewing him, he has like a little like Krang type Asian bitch who might be Hawaiian who's like ghost white. Like she literally looks like a gremlin became a human and is screaming at people. No one's answering a single fucking question. And then the chief of police is the dude from LAPD or from Vegas. Las Vegas shooting. You brought up a fucking good point that this dude, Vegas, like, imagine shitting the bed so hard that fucking Vegas happened.
Yeah, man.
Normal story. Paddock brought all those
I
fucking...
I freaked out one time so hard on a $1,900 cabinet job where the paint peeled.
Yeah.
And I was like, I'm never going to get another job.
You're done.
And a cabinet coat, it had just come out. They told me it would work. It didn't work. They did not back me up.
Yeah.
All they'll give you is free juice. All they'll give you is 2 gallons.
You have to redo the whole thing. You have to, yeah. I mean, you can't even do it at that point because then you got to like skim the cabinets with like Bondo or some shit.
Just put your hands up and say, I'm sorry.
But that's what I'm saying. Like,
I was a kid.
Vegas, literally one of the fucking worst mass shootings in America.
Well, think about it like this. One of the more corrupt places in America.
Couldn't
and
be
always
more.
Has been since back when the syndicate was thriving.
Yeah.
And then this guy's fucks up or doesn't fuck up. Does a great job for them. And then they reward him with this cushy job where there's even more corruption right next
imagine
to the fucking
getting
NSA.
Fucking, he got a 25% raise. He's getting like, we saw that dude with the fucking platinum, dude. I think cops are getting paid more than we think because that dude got 200 G's to go work over in Lanai.
Yeah, I don't know.
That's so much fucking bread for a cop, dude.
I think if you're a chief of police, that probably makes sense.
Yeah,
in
maybe
a city.
Maybe I mean, they just get 200 grand. I'm fucking retarded.
That kind of makes sense.
Yeah, but he, like, the way that dude's responding to questions and shit is, you can tell something's up with the dude, the corner guy, because, like, dude, he's not answering fucking or the cop.
I mean, he did such a fucking bad job. There's conspiracy theories about Vegas. Now yeah. we got Route 91. Check it out.
What?
Route 91 Festival, the Harvest yeah. Festival. Check it out.
And that, I've never, ever since then, like, I'm not going to say, like, I was a Dan Bilzerian fanboy, but, like, I saw that shit, and I was like, dude, you're on a weird one if you're on the Instagram Live while there's a fucking mass shooting going on.
Yeah, yeah.
But, yeah, it's very, like, the odd shit is just that dude's there.
Like, he was the chief of police in a city where Saudis would come and play.
Yeah.
You know, so just think about that for a second.
Saudis and literally anyone yeah. with money who's usually trying to wash it.
Yeah.
You're the dirtiest dude in the world. Then you get shipped to Lanai after like 55 people get fucking shot.
In a place where they've been promoting the smart cities.
But dude, when we were reading that fucking PDF, I started fucking thinking about it. And if Obama is some sort of like dude behind the curtains pulling these strings, he is a Hawaiian native. That
wow, dude,
dude,
you're hitting me with some heavy shit this week.
That dude could have easily sat back.
I forgot that dude's from Hawaii. Allegedly.
Allegedly. Barry Sorrentino, whatever the yeah. fuck his name is. This dude's fucking chilling.
Bathhouse Barry talking to the chef.
Dude, supposedly he's straight up. Like, do you see the shit where he's like, I had gay fantasies?
Nah, come on, man.
Dude literally came out and was like, yeah, obviously I've thought about that shit.
Come on, man.
I mean, I don't know in what context, because you could ask anyone, like, have you ever thought of gay shit? It's like, yeah, obviously, like, you could do it right now. And I'm like, think of gay, you doing gay shit with dudes. Like, you thought of gay shit, right? So technically, yeah. everyone who's currently listening
technicality.
Just thought of gay yeah. shit. But, like, he was saying he had, like,
fan- And you did that to them.
Allegedly. But he was saying, like, he had all these fucking fantasies, whatever. Didn't read the article because it's just MSM fucking slop. I don't need that kind of feed.
Yeah, in the gay wars that we're having, you brought up a real good point this week about how the allyship, that's fucking weird.
Dude, it's Maoist. It's literally, like, that's what they use.
But I'm just saying, that's allies are in wars.
If you're not an ally, you're an access partner. I'm Hitler. if that's what it is.
Yeah.
And I'm not cool with what you're doing.
I just never thought of that shit. That whole thing's been around for years.
Dude, they LARP as some weird fucking militaristic thing.
Hey, dude.
Where it's like,
the lights are on, but nobody's home, brother.
I know. It's none of that shit sits right with me, but this stuff was happening with Obama. No one's talking about his boy that got killed. That dude was chilling in Martha's Vineyard. That was fucking happening, all this shit. There's so many things that could be happening.
Do you think he did some gay shit with the chef, or the chef saw it?
I think he rage quit,
and then he called in a strike on Hawaii.
No. I'm just saying it's convenient, and it made me think of him. And like, I personally, I think that like maybe Mike saw what was going down. I don't think she's a jealous type, honestly, but maybe Obama like pulled one.
Thank you for using her correct gender.
Maybe he pulled a freak out, like one of those like, what the fuck? Why did I just kiss you? I'm not a fucking faggot. And just beat the shit out of him and drown him. Maybe that fucking happened. I have no idea. If you were to do gay shit, I could see
how much you thought about this.
I'm just saying, like, if he did some stuff like that, for some reason, I was talking to my cousin for literally no reason. We just started talking about something, and I just started telling him, I heard that you made out this dude and then punched him in the face. It was like my uncle's wife's fucking nephew who's gay. And I was like, dude, I heard at a family party you kissed him and then punched him in the face and said you weren't gay. These are just things I do in my spare time. But dude,
do a little trolling. A little trolling.
But it was going way. It's the same shit with COVID with Hawaii where it goes way, way above and beyond to where, like, I'm looking at a fucking fire. Like Jones was saying, what do you need to start a fire? A match, dry shit. Little bit of gas. That's what they did. You can look it up in all the fucking California wildfires.
Well, they're suing HECO or whatever the fuck their PECO is.
Obviously, dude.
Because I think BlackRock or Vanguard or one of those guys is in on this.
Yeah, they fucking own.
And they own
everything.
The telephone line. They own the infrastructure. I think that's what they do. They build it. That's why I think they have the contract.
Disaster capitalism, bro. They do it everywhere they fucking go.
Yeah, I think they're like the new guys for this. Where they, like, that's how they got the contract for rebuilding the Ukraine.
I would love to see who owns DTLR and fucking Finish Line or whatever, because for some reason when all those George Floyd riots happened, every single one of them lit on fire.
Yeah, right.
Unless that, but like, it's the same shit with the Opportunity Zones where it's like a big fucking thing's happening and it's weird. Like, I've saw the drone shots and they're weird because you can see that it's just going, it's like a line going right for the shit it's supposed to. But allegedly, there's a bunch of water diversion that could stop those fires from hitting the fucking big houses. I'm also in the line of thinking that maybe the houses have their own fucking water systems. Because I don't see, like, rich people, the way they fucking look at us, there's no way they're hitting the same water as us.
For drinking.
For drinking, for bathing. Dude, water's so bad. Like, there's all those forever chemicals.
They say that, I forget the guy. It's the guy from fucking, The Big Short. Michael Blurry.
Yeah.
He said that the next war will be for water.
Well, dude, like, there's no way these, like, there's no way rich people, maybe they have, what's it called, filters and shit like that. But, yeah, like, yeah. Dude, the biggest thing, you can absorb so much shit on your skin. The aluminum they're putting in fucking deodorants and shampoos, and there's still water going on your skin with yeah. all those forever
that
chemicals on it.
That was a big psyop when I was a kid. It was the Gillette wet gels.
What about them?
So everybody was, like, getting these things, and it was, like, tons of commercials, and who knows? I don't know what kids are involved with now with commercials or whatever, but you would be like, all right, dude, I need this deodorant.
Yeah.
And it was nothing but fucking aluminum. And then they came out saying, like, oh, man, you're kind of fucked. It causes Alzheimer's.
Yeah.
And then they ran a scam fucking making Alzheimer's medicine, and Vivek fucking Ramaswamy scammed everybody because that's what they do. They sit in a room on phones and tell everybody they went to the moon.
I know.
And on the dark side that you can't see.
That is literally like I hooked up with a girl. She's from a different town. Yeah. You don't know her. Like, for the Indians to go to the dark side of the moon is just fucking insane.
Yeah, you get like that dude Vivek where it's like, man, you ran like a legitimate fucking drug scam. Chilling. And then repeating a word for word Obama's line.
That was tough.
So maybe he'll win and maybe Obama will be president for 24 years. But he's definitely president now.
Dude, but like I feel like there's,
or Biden's cranking him around. Who the fuck knows? This is the deep state.
Yes, yeah. And I think we're on a fucking psyop train, and we just haven't said, "All right, I'm cool here. I'm getting the fuck off." Because there's shit that Vivek dude's saying where people are like, "Dude, why wouldn't you vote for him? He's going right against fucking big pharma and all this stuff." It's like, dude, it's all fake. Like the way this dude talks when he was 18 until now. Yeah, I would never.
Nah. Yeah, it's fucked up.
I cannot trust that dude.
Yeah.
He's literally copying everyone I know.
Total
Indian move. He's literally being the most Indian dude on the planet. Scammed a bunch of people, and he's just stealing everyone's fucking shit.
I can't wrap my head around the soft-spoken Trump. Like the podcast with Tucker, when he's doing that.
I mean, he's the wolf with all the arrows in his back protecting you, the cub.
He's doing all that talking where he's like, it's like hypnotic.
Puts me out.
Where I just zone the fuck out. And he'll talk for like 40 seconds or a minute and say nothing. It's crazy.
I don't know.
He's talking about like water could be good. It could be bad. You never know. It falls from the sky. It's like, yeah, man, we know what water is.
And dude, like maybe he was maybe talking with a little more like oomph and shit. But like when he was talking before that, we were completely entranced in a psyop where, like, dude, you got to pay attention to what this motherfucker's saying because there's secret words.
Oh, yeah.
And now when you're listening, it's like, dude, this guy just says everything at once. And, like, the people who are running psyops are like, dude, put Trump in. We'll say he's saying coded messages because he never finishes a fucking sentence.
Yeah, and he's a media beast and he's a brander. So he could walk into the new modern world and just be like, oh, I'll be president, no problem.
Dude, I was listening.
He's a hype beast.
I was listening to that fucking Tucker Carlson. And he never finished a fucking sentence.
Yeah.
It's kind of sick.
Yeah, and Tucker just laughs like a maniac.
And, like, dude.
None of that shit was funny.
Yeah, he's there. It's all fucking, you've never shot called something harder than when you said all this shit is becoming vaudeville.
Oh, yeah.
Because, like, when I turned that, like, I used to
be. They got to run another media cycle. What I mean, do you there's mean? There's cool, like, I don't know. There's cool, like, I love that Patrick Byrne story.
Obviously.
That's like some, that, like, if you give me some fictional shit like that.
But, dude, what that is a dude when it's like, dude, just give me your fucking best.
Yeah, like that. And there's some of the ones that are some of the best, I think, are like, all right, man, like, fucking every 100 years, they just run another fucking, it's like an extended three or four generation PSYOP. And you, by the time you realize it, you're one of the geezers.
Yeah.
And you can't tell the youth.
And then fucking your kids hate you.
They're living in another world.
Yes.
And they just know how to do this. And it's just social control. It's just the king in the castle. And the peasants are just out there like, do you still have the peasants working? Are they attacking the castle right now? No, you're doing a good job.
Yeah.
That's it.
Dude, it does make sense.
They're not coming for our heads. Okay, cool. We're winning. We live another day. It's probably so scary to be that rich.
Oh my God!
It's right. Like if you're over,
they like, dude, they don't even get shot at. There's like people for the one company I do work for. There's a lady.
They were gonna put kiddie porn on fucking Trump's computer.
Dude, like they get bulletproof glass, not because they're gangsters, not because of anything, literally just because they have so much money.
Yeah.
Imagine being that paranoid just because your bank account's huge and you're like, dude, I gotta.
Oh yeah, like imagine like getting money and then you like it made enemies.
Yeah.
People like, I want to take what he has.
This is why I think all this stuff's like so crazy, because the people who are at the top have so many enemies, and like anything that happens, you're like paranoid the fuck out. Like, dude, that was a fucking hit on me. Obviously, I'm going to have to retaliate or else I'm going to look weak.
Yeah, and I mean, dude, if you grew up, like that guy's story is a great story in the way that he says he grew up and everything, and it's like you definitely could skits out. You could talk to some people and think you're an FBI asset.
Yes.
And really, you just kind of hooked up with a Russian chick one time. And you talk to some people, like, who knows what's real?
It could just be, like, every now and then you're just touching the truth a little bit, and then you just go a little bit away from the truth, but you reel back in, like, because I told you earlier, that is why I was over in Azerbaijan. That's exactly why.
Yeah.
You could have just been over there because you're rich.
Yeah, but going on, like, little media tours and telling everybody that you set up a sting for Hillary, that you, like, he's the reason there's Russian collusion.
Yeah.
Like, so he freaked out when he realized he was just another pawn in the deep state game.
Yes. It's very believable. Yeah, like, when
I love it, and I wish it was a TV show.
When I read that, I was fully on board. Then you started talking shit on it. It's literally like when everyone's
I'm not talking shit on it, dude. It's
not
just
talking
like,
shit on it. Like, you're just speaking logically. We're looking at it with a logical brain, not a dude who is on Suboxone, dying for hopium.
Yeah, do you want me to go down another Pied Piper one? Yeah, sure, we could do that together. That'd be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
But, I mean, we don't have to do that to ourselves.
But, like, when you do that, I'm like DeSantis when he was
the
on
real
stage,
story,
just raised his hand, like, oh, yeah, I'm with Trump, too.
Like, the real Pied Piper story is scary. So, I mean, fucking, you don't want to do this. You don't want to follow the White Hats. No one's coming to get you. It's a child's mentation.
Dude, Passio was 100% right on that. But, like, dude, back to the fucking Hawaii shit. All this, like, they're going way too far out with what they think happened. Direct energy weapons, dude, literally suck my fucking dick if you think direct energy weapons started that. You're out of your fucking mind. And, like, it's so bad.
But if they didn't fill your mind with some of that stuff, you might start following the money.
That's what I'm saying. Like, it's,
you know, so
it's
then you're like, I don't want to do that. Or, like, would they give the families like $700?
$700. Ukraine is getting so much money. Yeah. And I literally think they did that just so I get pissed at it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's part of the deal.
It's 100% what it is. Like, there's, oh, no, it's not. That's not what I got mad about. I was watching Hustle Bitch. The one dude is really going, Hustle Bitch is going in on fucking Maui. That dude was doing like stimulus check shit. And out of nowhere, he has a sick backdrop. And he's just, he is the most down the line dude I've seen on the Hawaii shit. And fucking remember that shit came out about FEMA and the Marines going at it with
I mean, you
in
can't
a gunfight.
You can't be doing that to me.
That's like the USS Liberty coming up to fucking save all the people in New York during COVID.
Yeah,
like I can't. I read that and I was like, dude, a young me would have jumped on that and sent it to the group chat.
Right.
The really crazy thing about FEMA, thanks to Hustle Bitch, is they gave $700 all those fucks in Hawaii.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to start roasting the fucking Hawaiians after watching that shit. They're literally pissing me off. Like, the way they talk pisses me off, but, like, Lahaina Strong, obviously, fuck Bezos. But this dude is saying that they got $700. FEMA's there. when you think of FEMA, they're cleaning up natural disasters, right?
Yeah.
A day's in at, in Hawaii, you can get one for $200 a night. Little steep. The director of FEMA was claiming that they're having money issues. They're staying at five-star resorts that are around $1,500 to $4,000 a night to do this cleanup. Dude, a night.
I mean, they get kickback city, dude. FEMA's kickback city.
It's fucking crazy.
They're going to be dishing out contracts to rebuild. But this is going to be something weird. Remember I was telling you, like, when they did Katrina, that was poverty-stricken area.
Yeah.
Wipe it the fuck out.
Although, dude, people were getting paid. The roofers were getting, like, 15 G's to tarp a fucking roof down.
Well,
there.
No.
Something wild.
The GCs were.
Yeah.
But then it was, like, subs to subs to subs.
Yeah. Ukrainians.
Yeah. So, but this is the second most expensive real estate in the world.
Yeah.
So this is fucking crazy.
This is their best.
Yeah.
That's like, but Jones was saying, what Jones was saying made the most sense, and Alexander Hamrick has been on a fucking roll.
Oh, dude, don't get me started on the lockdowns.
Yeah, we'll get there. Fucking, he was talking about that shit in California. There was tons of people arrested starting those fucking fires. It would be so easy, especially if you got a greaseball freak like that fucking chief of police and that dumbass mayor with his weird crank bitch. I swear to dude, look up Mayor's Helper or Hawaiian's Mayor Helper. You'll freak the fuck out.
I don't know where my phone is.
All you have to do is, like, you don't need direct energy weapons. You don't need Space Force fucking doing this for fucking BlackRock. You just need to push over some shit. In a fucking hurricane, make sure the shit that needs to not catch on fire has water to it, and all the other places get water fucking axed.
Yeah, I don't even think it's that. I know that for years Maui's had bad traffic problems because I was checking out this old shit. You can look at, like, old tweets and stuff.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Like, they've always had problems with this stuff, and I think it's one of those things where it starts happening, and it's like the Rahm Emanuel thing, like, let's take advantage of a crisis.
Mm-hmm.
Like, never let a crisis go to waste. Like, they sit there and just go, wait, what's going on? Keep the power on.
Yeah.
And they'd be like, here, dude, maybe. I'm just saying, hypothetically, if I want to put my Patrick Byrne white hat on and play the flute, sit there. What if I'm in a little fucking tent and I lay out.
Talk about this in the skiff.
I lay out a map. Yeah, we're in a skiff. I lay out a map and go, here's where the fire's headed.
Yeah.
And then just circle where the real estate's going to be and just go, not even say anything, and just look for head nods.
Yeah.
That's it. That's all you got to do.
No one has to consent to it, but yep. You turn the power off, right? I think so.
You just show it. Look at the chief of police. He knows what to do. He knows how to fuck this up.
I mean, that dude has watched 55 people get fucking shot and didn't flinch and got a raise. Yeah.
Never investigated Mandalay Bay.
Are you serious?
I don't. Dude, they never did any of this shit. That was the thing with
Patrick Byrne.
When Tuck was talking to Trump, they're like talking about the Epstein thing. And that was something that I wanted to hear, you know?
Yeah, did they? They never actually investigated, right?
Well, I mean, they just said, case closed, he killed himself.
That's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
And then you're hearing about nitrous oxide and all the fucking guards are down.
Yeah, it is.
They went sleepies for the night. Like, that's crazy shit.
Yeah.
And you never know what's real or not. And then you just live in this world where you're just floating around.
Yeah.
None of it really matters. You might as well just fucking do something else.
Yeah. Do literally anything, but like.
And how fun is it, though,
when it's
the good stuff?
When it's the good stuff, it makes sense. But, like, so like I fucking had to just, like, step off everything. And
like a bad error in wrestling.
Yeah. I'm just like, this is, like, gay shit. I'm not looking at anything. I just listened to Bandot video.
Well, didn't you get hit with, like, a weird astrological thing where you're in, like, a
Makes more sense now. Actually, Mercury's in retrograde as well as seven other planets. So
whatever it
in,
is,
dude.
It was like, what was the word you used?
What?
I can't remember the word you were saying. Stagnant.
Stagnant.
You
yes.
Say stagnant. Yeah.
Dude, I fucking
just have zero interest.
It's overload.
It's overload. Yeah, it's tough, man.
Oh my god, I keep farting. It's fucking. It's not even that. Like, I see all the shit going on online. And everyone's saying the fucking same shit. And you're like, I was just like, dude, like, this is fucking literally just to fuck with me. It's like when you figure out someone's finally fucking with you, you're like, I'm not even going to be mad, dude. Like, say whatever you want.
Yeah, yeah.
I know you're fucking with me. So I just have to chill the fuck out.
You just got
to
sit and not make eye contact and just kind of bite your lip.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just think about
it. I'm getting roasted right now. Yeah. I know. Yep.
It is what, like, I watched all that shit happen.
You'll see.
And it got, like, the worst part is, I watch all that happen, then, like, it's like, well, what, like, people hit me up, like, what do you think about this? Like, dude, I don't fucking know. I'm in Philadelphia and I'm watching black dudes on TikTok explain what's happening in Hawaii. And then,
oh, man, TikTok for me is a fucking, that's a crazy one, man. Cause I'm trying to like get stuff done.
Oh, it's impossible.
And I hit that, the Colorado Pet Patrol. And watching these guys
wipe your day.
Watching these guys try to talk themselves out of, I mean, these guys are holding binders, playing audio clips of them talking to one of the decoys.
Yeah.
The shit these guys are doing for decoys, like, this is a kind of horny that shouldn't exist.
None, like, you hit the nail on the head with, like, even if it wasn't Colorado Pet Patrol and it was, like, some dude rolled up, like, Andrew, you were talking to Stacey for the last fucking month.
Oh,
and it was an of-age woman.
Oh, yeah, even if it was a chick.
I'm like, dude, like, guys, seriously, cut this off. I'm going to have a panic attack. Can you please not do this to me?
Yeah, Matt and his boy did this to me with a girl that I had a crush on.
Oh, my God,
and dude. Bert was texting me, and I thought we were going to go to the movies, and I was, like, trying to riz her on text. And the whole time it was Bert.
Jesus Christ. Did they fuck with you?
Yeah, they were fucking with Matt. It was Matt and Phil were fucking with me.
Yeah, Matt was trying to get the sting off him. When I fucking got Matt with his love letters in London, dude, he was fucking pissed. Yeah, but dude, that shit, like, I don't know what it is about that. Like, maybe, like, you know, like, Tommy Pope likes to watch those death videos?
Yeah, yeah.
It's just, there's, like, I was driving the trash truck.
Well, they get you on the TikTok because it's part one.
Yeah.
And then you're like,
I'm straight on YouTube. I'm long format.
Yeah.
I'm subscribed to CPP on fucking YouTube. And I'm driving trash trucks just like trying to back in somewhere. And like I'll pull up and I'll see like people have to move cars. I'm like, fucking thank God. I pull the air brake and I just start watching. It's like, why did you tell her that you want to shove a hairbrush stick?
What are you doing at the ATM? Yeah. Get money for Amber.
Dude.
What were you going to do with Amber today?
I'm surprised there isn't more murders with those. Like, that shit's so dangerous to do. The fact that those dudes aren't rolling strap is fucking insane.
Yeah. I watched one guy chase him down with a knife. And he was begging for his life.
Who was begging for his life?
Colorado Pet Patrol.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
What was the dude's problem?
Like, he ran from the, I mean, dude, he came. He was like, yo, we're busting you. We're going to call the cops. The dude just literally turned around with a weapon and chased him. He was like, I'll stop.
Jesus.
Oh, yeah, he's running from me. He's like, all right, dude, sorry. He's, like, apologizing to pedo.
An alpha fucking chomo.
Oh, yeah.
It is, like, I don't know how, like,
if that's do or die, dude.
Oh, my.
You're being videotaped.
But that's what I don't get. Those dudes just sit there and, like, I don't understand how they're standing. When those dudes hit him with the binder.
Yeah. I mean, bro, there was one I watched where the guy literally sat down.
It's not even that.
He's sitting down at a restaurant waiting for a 14-year-old boy.
Yes.
And the patrol rolls in and sits down. And he just starts going, oh, no. No.
Is that the one where he's like, you want to talk? He's like, no. Do you want to get coffee? No. Do you want me to call the cops? No.
He
doesn't know what the fuck to say.
He doesn't know what's going on. The guy's like, you were here to rape a 14-year-old. He's like, it's not rape. And he's like, I was going to see what was happening if he wanted it. And they're like, you understand what consent is, right? The guy's like, yeah, I understand. And he's like, what's the age of consent? He's like, it was 17. I mean, he's 14, though. It's like, dude, you're busted. And then it turned out he was already registered in Iowa. So he was all he's. They can't stop, dude.
That's why I think
put these guys in the fucking FEMA camps. We're good people.
Yeah, that's why I think like at that point, if it's like one, you get fucked up on a charge.
Yeah.
If it's two, and you're like Pet Patrol bust you, like if you have like a good case against you, and you're saying some like
fucking death race them, put them in some weird arena, and just guys that need thrill kills, and then guys that need to go.
And dude, just that's fucking not a bad put it idea.
To bread and circus, dude. Let's take this to the next level.
That's where I kind of went with watching that shit, where it's like, dude, I wish there was ones where, like, they killed him. Like, I was watching that, like, there's probably, like, snuff videos where they kill this guy.
Yeah, I'm not then trying to see
I'm anything. Not trying to become the monster.
Yeah, I'm not a monster. I don't like to see anybody get fucked up. I can't watch any videos where I know someone's getting fucked up.
But, like, dude, these, like...
Like, that weightlifting shit when their knees are blunt, like, I'm not watching that stuff.
Nah, it's bad for business. But, like, I think you're right with, like, most of these dudes have to be somewhat retarded to fall for this.
Some of them are, yeah, but some of them are fucking monsters.
Some are just fucking horny, but it seems like a solid amount.
It's all fantasy. It's all fantasy. I never do it.
Yeah.
Never do it in real life.
I don't know how you, like, the...
Teddy.
The post of that, of when it's just like, they busted me, and the cops didn't come this time. And then it's like, so like, holy shit, dude, did you see this guy was on and just slowly goes around to people? I would fucking kill myself, dude. if that shit was up there, I would go in hiding if it was a normal age girl. If that happened to me, I would legitimately take my own fucking life or go and do something so heroic. Like, I would just say, find the worst guy in the world, dude. I'll charge him. I'm going to fucking make up for this one.
They thirst, but like, it's not like the politicians build rings to do this carte blanche. So they do this like, however, like they do sum quique, bro. To each their own. They're like, it's cool. This is what I'm into. They have other rules, man.
It must be such a fucking like crazy feeling once you get up to like the elites. And you're like, dude, so we can just do this whenever you want. I'll kill whoever you want.
Yeah, you can do whatever you want. They make their own rules. This is like the British, the royal family. That's what they say. Like Lord Mountbatten was going into this Kincora place. Like it's nothing. When they go get coronated, they're on the same floor as the Freemasons temple.
Yeah.
They're on the same floor as the White House. Patrick Burns got a selfie where he's sitting there in front of the checker floor. That's in the White House, dude.
Yeah. And that's
in the Capitol building. Like all of our places are all Masons.
True.
And all this goes back to this weird brotherly love and self-improvement shit.
Gay shit.
I mean, who the fuck knows? I don't know. Yeah. Ben Franklin was one. He's kind of a Chad.
True. I mean, but he also did have like a building with like a bunch of bodies in his basement.
Yeah. So they do. They're the president of these chapters for like 2 years. Ben Franklin was it when he was 28.
What?
But that was like middle age back then. That would have been like being 40.
Yeah. I mean, I'm excited just to, I got nothing else for that. The fucking.
Okay. Moving on.
Yeah. The fucking Jones shit. Of him coming out with that mass lockdown.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah.
I think they might be priming this motherfucker to be like the guy for 2024 and stuff. Because there's no money left in this. And like, oh my, dude, literally just keep ripping ass. There's no money in Fox. CNN's fucking dead. He joins up with Steven Crowder. Steven Crowder's has to have fucking paper because he turned down the Daily Caller fucking millions.
I never got it. I don't know what he's up to. I'm not into the Mug Club commercials on Jones.
But dude, it's like it's almost like you know how CNN and Fox.
It's like when they make when it's like when fucking there's like a DC guy and a Marvel thing. You're like, yo, no, what is this?
But the thing is, all of that money, like they did their final act with presented by Pfizer, all this stuff. Like it's about to be a fucking atomic hell.
That was the prologue, brother.
That's all the money they could have ever made. It's like, yeah, Murdoch was probably just like, yeah, back it up. No fucking problem. Daily Caller is fucking retarded. Like Ben Shapiro's a bitch, right?
Is this all Steven Crowder stuff?
No.
No.
There was a beef between Daily Caller and Steven Crowder. Steven Crowder was like getting courted by Ben Shapiro. His financial shit is fucking weird. He and who Ben Shapiro and who else went over to was it Lex Friedman went and chilled with BB?
I don't know, but dude, how about that picture I sent you of fucking Peterson in that fucking jacket?
He's a fucking Peterson and fucking
that dude's out of his fucking skull. His gear is insane.
So I think Daily Caller obviously has some fucking deep pockets.
Yeah, right.
They try to get Steven Crowder for something crazy, like $50 million. They wanted Steven Crowder for $50 million.
Okay.
To change, like, do Change Your Minds, do Louder with Crowder, what the fuck ever.
It's crazy to think that would be worth that.
That's what I'm, like, it seems like the winds are shifting, and everyone who is dying currently is like, let me turn on Gutfield to see what's really happening in fucking Hawaii. This motherfucker tells the truth. He's cursed a few times. Yeah. All of those people are dying.
At the Super Bowl, they said he's going to have a late night show. He's going to be the new king of late night. I don't know if that started yet or not.
I mean, he might be.
That was a while back, yeah.
But I swear to God, I think they're just going to slowly, like, you have what I don't pay attention to the left-leaning stuff, and it's a little fucking weird, like the Hassan Piker, Midas Touch people. It might just start to become, like, online conglomerates. But Jones and Crowder are teaming up, and I think Jones might be getting pushed as like the dude for the right wing.
Like the, I mean, hey, you see, this is just a theory you got kicking around.
It's a theory I got kicking around, but he came out with that fucking, we're going to have to mask up and go back to COVID lockdowns, and then the news did it, like, the next, like, 3 days later, the news came out with that.
Yeah, I know.
So, like, they're like, he's...
It's a whistleblower.
But it is, it's weird that, like, he's getting a, him and Crowder just don't, I don't like this.
Okay, all right.
Because I was showing, like, Jones already had his one... where he said a little bit too much about a certain country and then just fucking kind of chilled out. And then he did his fucking thing. They tried to kill him with Sandy Hook. You can't kill him. He's already dead. He's been to the third fucking level. And now he's with fucking Crowder doing the Mug Club. Something weird is going to be happening with that shit. I'm still going to tune into
InfoWars. So you're saying Jones is on Crowder's show?
They're together.
That's a show now?
I don't know if it's a show, but like Jones is bankrupt. So him and Crowder are now, like, teaming up because he was, like, filling in for Crowder and shit, and I guess they're boys, and now they're teaming up. Do with that information whatever the fuck you want.
Okay, yeah.
It's just something to keep an eye out on. But he, like...
These internet shows are not grassroots is what you're saying. This is AstroTurf.
50 million, dude?
This is AstroTurf.
It's weird that fucking... If he's... No one's going to offer you $50 million out of the blue.
Nope.
The fucking guys, the money changers who come up with those numbers, someone else is offering fucking Steven Crowder $50 million. Ben Shapiro's weird ass isn't coming up with that number out of nowhere. There's no way the Mug Club is worth that fucking much.
Yeah.
So I think these dudes are just fucking going and starting to do like...
All this shit confuses shit out of me. Like when they say they get paid all this money on the ads on fucking shows, like internet shows, podcasts, like is it? There's no way they're getting that money back.
Dude, ads make no sense.
They don't make any sense.
Yeah. You've never got me with an ad.
I've never bought anything.
It's always skip past it.
Yeah.
I don't want fucking Magic Spoon. I don't want BetterHelp.
Yeah.
BetterHelp is fucking terrifying. I used to like Tim Dillon's
commercials, though.
Yeah, Tim Dillon's commercials hilarious. But like that shit BetterHelp put out that I sent you, of that black dude who's a girl with a mustache and was like...
Oh, that's a BetterHelp thing?
That's a BetterHelp ad.
That's nuts.
It's fucking... like, and dude, you fucked me up by telling me that they're giving tranny pills away for free.
Yes, and that's inside information.
Yeah, whatever the fuck that is.
The trans and care that they're giving kids, there's no bills. So that at that point,
kids are dying of cancer, and the parents are remortgaging their house to cure the cancer.
At this point, you're a hormonal experiment.
It's some fucking wild shit, and that's why I believe that Patrick Byrne shit of like there's some sort of like Maoist revolution within. Because if you watch,
I mean, that's 100% true.
Oh yeah,
that's been going on. Yeah, that's true.
It's weird though that they want you to be a tranny.
When you're telling me stories and there's a...
And you're saying you're banging 10 out of 10.
There's a Russian honeypot. And then like Arlen Specter taps you on the shoulder when you're 43 and says, dude, we want you to take down the corruption in the country. We love you. Like Arlen Specter came up with the match bullet theory.
Yeah, it's hard to believe. There are some dudes in that.
Like he might be one of the more evil guys that has lived.
Yeah, and a huge fucking liar. Yeah. But like he's saying like he's doing that show with Warren Buffett. And the thing that pissed me off is like I started getting texts. Do you actually think we're going into fucking lockdowns? Like, there's no way this can fucking happen. And, like, dude, I literally think my thoughts create reality because now I'm seeing all these people with fucking masks. Warren Buffett, Patrick Byrne's fucking rabbi, came out and he goes, oh, there's going to be another one. Like, it's normal. It's the same shit with the demoralization where, like...
Well, we might be in World War III and it's a bio war on us and a depopulation plan by... a group of people that want to live in a world with less people.
Dude, what's wrong with a hangout?
Yeah.
Like, they have islands.
You don't want to hang out with everybody.
I don't want to hang out with everyone, but if I had an island, I wouldn't be sweating it.
I mean, there's studies that you can't hang out with people that are one standard IQ deviation away from you.
Look at us.
So, if you were one of them, they can't chill here.
But they have islands.
They couldn't pull up on a Trevor and chill with us. So if we exist, to them, we're useless eaters. Humans need to go bye-bye.
I watched it happen when I was doing that dude's bad idea.
That's the thing with the Maoist thing. It's like they create good people and bad people. When the guy said that there's
allies.
Like, there's, what was the fucking thing? There's fools and there's knaves.
Yes.
And then there's the elite that will protect the fools from the knaves.
Yes.
And that's the whole deal. I was cracking up. Knaves is a nice one.
And this is the same shit you were talking about. like OG COVID shit where it's like the people that were a little richer were supposed to be the ones fucking telling us what the fuck is good.
But the people, as far as I see it, I mean, I used to be hung up on this when I was younger, but like if you live in America, you basically live, this is the place where like Vivek type dudes can come over from another country and through hard work in generations.
Yeah.
So if you're here for an X amount of generations and you just didn't fuck up, you kind of have like generational wealth and like that's like intellectual wealth too. Like you get to go to college.
It's like saving up.
Yeah, like if you like eventually your kids will get smarter, a little bit smarter, a little bit better and all this other stuff.
Yeah.
And like the kids that the people that had the master's degrees and the PhDs shouldn't have been tricked by the corporate global elite. But they've been on easy street. Like you, like was I talking to you when you said the girl from Brown, they hit her with a mat? Yeah, so it's like that kind of thing.
She had a mental breakdown because she couldn't get out of
New York. You're going to an Ivy League school and like you can't read a map and function in the world.
Yeah.
So like it's gotten disconnected from the real world.
There's no more Thomas Souls and shit like that.
The world's getting fragmented, man.
Yes.
So these people will never interact. They'll live in a bubble on the internet and then in real life, especially if you're working from home, if they take away the office, those people stop socializing. So the white, like upper middle class and like white collar jobs, they'll just stop socializing.
They can't put a chill on.
I mean, dude, fucking, they don't have to show up and meet new people and just go, I have to be with this person today. They get to curate their entire life.
Yeah, it's fucking
sick. So they sit there and just go, I don't want to be around this person, I'm leaving.
Yeah, then it just turns into squads on the beach.
Yeah. So, I mean, they just pick they're picking their friends, they're picking their partners. Didn't you tell me that they had, like, an elite dating thing where they...
What the fuck, yeah. Raya or some shit?
Yeah,
yeah,
they have all their own shit. Like you were telling, or when we were doing the fucking Hunter thing, and they're doing Zelle. I never heard of Zelle. I have Cash App. If I'm a peasant.
I mean, dude, if you want like the best representation of what it's like for an elite to try to hang out with a fucking normal guy,
yeah,
throw on Cocktail and watch him fucking meet Mr. Mooney.
Yeah,
dude.
Yeah, Mr. Mooney.
He fucking Mr. Mooney hates him. His daughter's not gonna get knocked up by some bartender, dude.
Yeah, when I was painting that dude's pergola. He had retired at 40 or 39 from mergers and acquisitions.
Yeah.
Whatever the fuck that is. And he thought it was totally normal for me. I'm doing the Ipe rosewood stain on like a real nice hardwood and I'm walking across. So I'm standing on a pergola. I climbed up it.
Yeah.
I don't have the best knees and ankles in the world.
You used to.
And fucking, he's flying a drone around me. He thinks it's funny.
Oh my
like,
God.
He's like chilling and I was like, yo, dude, what the fuck? And he's just laughing at me. Literally, we'll like, not make eye contact and laugh at you.
It's fucking with a dog.
Yeah, and then like they got a pool built and they dug the pool out and then there was a fight between the husband and the wife and they were arguing over it needs to be 8 inches deeper. And that was an argument that they had and then they had to redo the pool. So they'll like if you're doing those kind of fights, like you're out in space if you're me.
Yeah, you're
maybe I'm just sitting there just going like, what is going on? And they're nickel and diming me on my price. And I was 12 grand under the next guy.
It hurts, dude.
I'm retarded.
There
is a special fucking case, dude.
I will say this as a fucking just a rolling threat to all rich people. Don't fucking smite. If me and you were chilling, don't fucking smite me. Because the last fucking rich person that smite me fucking lost his leg in a fucking car crash.
Yeah,
dude.
Yeah. I don't like the hexes that you perform.
I will throw a fucking hex on anyone.
You might be doing this shit in your sleep. Who the fuck knows?
Dude, I'm talking right now in my sleep and it's not any sort of like normal sentence. I'm just looking at the sweet angel just going,
oh, you're not using the app, you have another person.
What's that?
You're not using the app.
What app?
That records your sleep.
Oh no,
you have another person telling you
there's
this?
Another person telling me that I'm asking her about the door. I'm like, he's at the door. I'm in the middle of the night. I'm talking about he's at the door. Like my sleep, my dreams are like, I'm at the point right now where I'm falling asleep where I'm like, dude, give me a dreamless night. Just give me fucking the void. I don't want to fucking have a dream about anything.
That shit fucks me up because the only dude that I know that died told me that it's just black. There's nothing. And he came back. Like, the only guy I know that. He was dead for 20 minutes and came back.
But, there's a whole Beast. YouTube channel of NDEs.
Beast Plumber. Yeah, I mean, but who knows, dude? I watch those trip
reports. Your guess is as good as mine.
I watch those trip reports and I'm like, that's not real. You know what I mean?
True.
So...
Yeah, I mean, it could be a wild cope, but that's what, like, I was watching the drop, and, like, there's, like, for the last, like, 2 weeks, I was telling you I was, like, fucking stagnant, and then, like, I just get an eerie feeling where I'm watching this, and, like, the death thought comes, then, like, the thought that all this is happening comes, and I'm just like, I cannot believe that they're going to do the drop on fucking Super Bowl Sunday. Yeah, yeah. I just slowly just walk back out of it. I get the fucking weirdest feelings. And then, like,
that's what happens to me. Like, that's why I get sucked in at night, especially. It's hard for me to, like, just go. It's hard for me to, like, just, like I have to obliterate myself with some kind of, like, media intake.
Yeah.
Like, I'm, like, Clockwork Orange. Like, I'm fucking conspiracy, like, Mel Gibson conspiracy theory. Like, I need my eyes. I need a screen to be blasting shit in my eyes.
You crave blue light.
I can't, like, just go to sleep. Like, I have to, like, wear myself out to sleep.
Well, I think that's one of, like...
Like, there's no part of me that's like, okay, it's time to go to bed now. Go upstairs and deal with your quiet mind.
Oh, no. It's literally, like, looking down into a fucking volcano.
That'll be, like, telling me about meditation. Like, oh, dude, I'm meditating. I'm just like, dude, there's no, at no point.
I meditate. It's like, pussy. You fucking loser. You fucking loser. You're an idiot.
Oh, I don't do that. I just can't shut it off.
Yeah, and that, dude, you know what that might fucking be from? The Red 40 and the BCAs and that intake? Because there's times where, like, if I'm, like, too, like, caffeined up, or, like, caffeine has long-ass fucking half-life, I'll be going to sleep and be like, dude, this is fucked. Like, the fucking thoughts that are going through my mind are driving me fucking insane.
Yeah, it was fucked up today when you were telling me that kids just go to school on ADHD or on, what do you call it, Adderall medicine. They go on Adderall.
You're done.
And you're just glued, like, hanging on every word of the teacher.
You're not.
And then you're not learning anything, really.
You're just
kind of fucked up.
Dude, I fucking, for all my college tests, for if I could get it, I took Adderall. I can't do long division right now. It doesn't stick with you. If you're on fucking Adderall, you're literally just a super slave for those fucking 8 hours.
Right.
And you're crushing their liver. And that's literally why that chick from Brown probably had a fucking panic attack. Because if you're just hanging on
the physiology of it all.
If you're just looking at someone like, this person is giving me all of the information. Like, dude, you're so locked in that, like, when I would be in the library at Temple, fucking bombs could be going off around me. And I'm just, like, PEMDASing the fuck up.
Oh, really? Okay.
So you're not paying attention to fucking shit. I could not imagine what that's like if that's your every fucking day.
When I signed up for the Speechify, it said that people with ADHD can read 3 times faster on Audible.
Yeah. And then there's another thing where it's like they highlight the beginning of words and it makes you read super fast if you do that.
Okay.
But it's just tricks of the trade for the ADD people. And, dude, I was thinking about that today. Like, you know, the founding fathers and all those dudes, it was like they were surveyors by fucking 13 and shit like that.
Yeah.
All this fucking ADHD and stuff, they might have just been able to fucking take in information. Because at this point, we're so fucked by the seed oils, the hyperactive shit, the ADD medication, where you're not retaining information.
They don't care. That's like open in the school system. There's files you can read where they're talking to each other. The elites that are the old guard that built the school system, the Rockefeller school system.
Yep.
We don't need any more Edisons.
Literally.
And they were like, we're good.
We need, like, everyone from the neck down.
They had all their inventions by the turn of the century. They got the transistor. They had electric light. And they're like, all right, let's go. Let's run some wars. Then they wiped out fucking masses of fucking dudes that are soldiers.
Yeah, all the bravies. But that's what when you were talking about the every 100 year thing, it seems like every now and then people start to fucking figure it out. Yeah. And it's like,
I'll hit my dad with some shit and he'll just be like, oh yeah, no. And in my head I'm going like, oh fuck, you're like 70.
Yeah.
You gotta figure it out on your own.
What do you mean?
Like, you as a person, you can't, like, sit there and listen to what your dad says, because what he's telling you doesn't make sense.
It's archaic.
Yeah. So you have to figure it out on your own. But, like, if you were sitting in a castle for the last seven, there's places in Europe where people have lived, families have lived for 700 years.
Yeah.
If you're living in that castle and people live on your land, you're in another realm, brother, of education and what's going on. And you're looking at people, you're like, you're living your life, but you're like a steward for your family and your name, and, like, it's just another life.
Dude. You're smart as shit.
Yeah, they know what's going. They know the bigger plan.
Yeah.
If you have, like, a bank that, if you're like a Medici, they're still around.
Yeah, and
it's
like,
not like they didn't make kids. I read an entire thing about how the Habsburgs died off, and it was a big fucking problem.
Why?
they like couldn't get a male heir. Like there was a whole weird thing with the Habsburgs where they just kind of died out, and like other families like they didn't want to marry him in. And
wasn't like Queen Elizabeth the Habsburg and shit.
I can't remember all the like the royal. They you can look that up though. You can look up like all the royal bloodlines. They have the German like they're. I can't remember all the shit, but
yeah.
There are like lines that have died off, but there's like ones that have never died off. So like the French or like the Merovingians, and then you can look at all that shit. Like they still exist, and they're like the richest people in the world. This shit of like Musk and stuff. These guys are actors. These guys are on the they're on the Masonic chessboard. There's dudes on the side moving the pieces.
Obviously, dude.
Yeah,
you're talking about the fucking people in the fucking shadows.
The black nobility.
Yeah, yeah. It is. It's insane if you think about it like that too, because it's, there's so much knowledge in that many generations. Then you hit like. Mexicans that are like Gen 2 here, and you could literally hit them with fucking
because if you're
anything.
Winning the game that hard, it's like you know what's going on.
Yeah.
You don't have to listen to the media is not for you. School's not for you. The media is not for you. You have your own bank, so the financial system's not for you.
Yeah.
You probably like
you get a loan whenever you want.
Like you're saying, they probably have their own springs where they
drink. They're not drinking our water. I can fucking tell you that 100%.
Man. Yeah.
If like they're like the only thing that's fucking. Tripping me out is the fact that like they usually run shit on a 100-year cycle, and it's that same shit Patrick Byrne was talking about where they did this fucking demoralization thing to us. They hit us with like the confusion spell.
This is where I get fucked up. Where sometimes I start thinking about this. So it's like you say like, oh, they run this thing, or do we just run it? We just
in
play,
the panopticon.
Like we just play out our roles.
Yeah,
and like fucking. This is just humans.
Mitochondria aren't thinking that they're the mitochondria. They just do, they're the powerhouse cell. That's literally what they do.
So they're just, so we're all just like out here just doing our thing. And it's like, this is just naturally how we are. And like that one book, the Fourth Turning book, that those guys came up with that theory where it's like, you have these different generations. They just act this way.
Yeah.
And they can trace it back like, you know, 500 years.
Yeah. But it like, it's fucking, it's weird that they did all that stuff. And now it's like, pandemic's going to happen next month. Like, it's weird that that's back on the table out of fucking nowhere.
What did you think of the SPARS 2025 to 2028?
It's
gearing up a RSV for the children.
Because I'm...
Like, the next...
I read it, and I'm just like, how, though? How would they do this again to us?
So, it was, like, in 2017, I think they came out with Disease X.
Yes.
And then they did a Clade X.
Clade X is on YouTube.
Did an Event 201, and...
The juiciness is Event 201 and Lockstep. Those are real juicy. I looked at Agenda 2030, and when you got to like decipher that shit because the whole thing they're just talking about.
Well, that's old Ike stuff.
Yeah, and they're like, "Oh, we just want no more poverty, none of this fucking shit." So
it's World Economic Forum. It's like a prototype.
Yeah, but them coming out with that Disease X shit and like those videos of fucking Gates talking like, "Oh, there's going to be another pandemic," like giddy, dude. And it's like, dude, you're not a good poker player. Like, I know your hand. You're showing your hand right now by laughing at talking about like a horrible pandemic, and you're giggling.
Was it Jones who was, like, fucking slowing down the smile?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, all right. Yeah.
I mean, dude, every day we're listening. We're on Infowars.com reading every fucking article. It's fucking crazy, though, because they're, like, if they do this, it's going to be, like, this is a shit where I'm like, dude, they got to do something for the election. This is a civil war. If they roll this shit back
you're
out.
You're going to say it. You're going to say the words.
What?
Civil war.
It is. Like, dude, if you're back on the fucking plane and they're telling you to put the mask on, if you're going in the wild, like, no, we got to mask up the numbers. It is going to be insanity.
Yeah, it's just the bootlickers, dude. It's the fucking, it's the jackboot Gestapo. They're the ones that are going to enforce it. They're the real criminals.
Yeah.
The people that enforce it this time, that's going to be wild. I get the first time.
Yeah, that was,
totally understand. I feel so...
High-level psyop on the entire fucking world.
I feel so sorry for all the people, but this time, there's a lot of quiet dudes that knew that was fucking bullshit. Dudes that lived...
Dudes that their fucking relationships got ruined.
Yeah, there's dudes that had We Believe in Science out on the lawn that survived. They're the real fucking...
What did Ed call it?
Huh?
What kind of science did Ed call it?
Company science. That company was great. Science. Yeah. Company science. You believe in science, you believe in the company science. Like the company store going back to the old industrial days.
Yes.
And, like, you had to unionize to go fight these fat cats.
Yeah.
And they got rid of them. I
thought you were about to call them something else, but all right, I'll go fat cats.
they killed them. They killed off all the power of the fucking little guy.
Yeah.
You know? So I'm just saying that there's a lot of guys that quietly fucking bit their lip. They went through it, and they're probably not going to do it again. You might see some real fucking dudes stand up and start being real dads. Be like, yo, no. Not this time. For real. Yeah.
It is like
a lot of homeschooling going to be going on, a lot of that shit.
Yeah, it seems like they're just going to run it through, like, all the fucking public schools and shit like that.
And they're going to fire a fuck ton of people.
Yeah.
They're just going to go through a whole thing of, like, yep, no work.
That's how, like...
That'll crucify. People are just getting back together now.
Well, that's why...
And they're raising the interest rates, which I don't pretend to understand at all.
Yeah. But. The number's higher than it was. That's all you have to know.
And I have heard that this isn't good.
According to the banksters, this is bad for us. It is. It's fucked up because, like, I read that timeline you sent me, and then I start going back to stuff, and I'm looking at, like, all the COVID shit that happened, and that's really fucked up. If you weren't next year's news today on that stuff, and you didn't see that they were just fucking with you, feel completely sorry for you. But then you go into, like, the Ukraine stuff, and it's like, dude, the people that just lied to you for that whole time hit you with a meaningless war.
Well, that one was a slant. That one they should have got. That was like the real. Proof of the power of the propaganda, because they should have got that one. We're talking about the same fucking people from Iraq.
Literally,
they should have got that one.
That's what we were spazzing when fucking Biden got elected. Like, dude, it's all Raytheon, all this shit. Like, you're not gonna get
they just should
free abortions forever and be able to trans whenever the fuck you want.
That's just that thing. Like, the people that are the elites that are supposed to protect us from the knaves, dude.
True. I just think if they do it this time, the only way they can roll it is if. It's the shit you said. The kids start getting hurt. And there's a huge chance that the kids could get hurt if they hit everyone with these bullshit-ass vaccines.
But that's what SPARS was, right?
Yes.
SPARS is a respiratory virus that is going to
It starts
hit,
in, like, Venezuela or some
kids,
shit.
Yeah.
In the South America.
And then they want to control misinformation again.
I mean, dude, it's literally exactly like Event 201. It's the same fucking thing. But this time, they'll hit you where it hurts, the fucking kids. And anything that has to do with fucking kids, you cannot fuck with.
No.
You're immediately a fucking monster. They'll freak the fuck out of you. But, dude.
Just hermit time.
I've been there, done that. It's going to be going back to like it wasn't COVID if this shit happens again, where it's just you got to talk to someone in code. It's like, oh, fuck. Yeah, you know, he's getting paid off this. Just slowly just inch shit out. Yeah. I'll go back to speaking the fucking code. If they do this, you know.
He's on into it.
It's fucking iron sport, building the fucking body, like exactly what I did. When this fucking happened, I was up to 120-pound dumbbells.
Yeah.
And you saw the dumbbells in iron sports. They're the fucking dusty one in iron sports.
Yeah.
That's a heavy-ass fucking dumbbell. Literally the only thing you can do. And at that point, like, I will preemptively get off all social media, none of that shit. I'll read all those books Patrick Byrne told us to read. I'll fucking ask you, what are some good movies? What are some good books? And that's fucking it, because they're not running some Activision shit like they did on us last time, where you literally had to submit to the BLM rulers to play COD. You had to acknowledge the fucking message you got from Activision about how Black Lives Matter, and you have to click this in order to play COD, and you're no longer allowed to say the N-word on COD.
Did that go away?
What?
Like, that's still going on, right?
No, all that BLM shit fucking came and went. But, you're getting, like, fucking turbo banned if you were hitting the N-word around that time.
Yeah, well, maybe...
There's, like, bots from fucking Activision that were getting you banned.
Yeah, they might have to...
But they weren't getting the black people, which was insane.
They might have to run, like, another fucking
revolution
type thing if they want to do that.
Going back to Trayvon, because, dude, I was just looking at something the other day. Remember?
It's got to be so confusing for them to just be like, dude, why are they still not wearing masks? We told them to wear masks. What's going on?
And it's a soft rollout, dude. Yeah. I mean, there's definitely
going to
be.
Oh, shit, they're not going along with it. Fuck.
There's definitely going to be people who are going to do it once the wintertime comes around and people start getting the fucking sniffles.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Like, that shit is going to be back more than ever. Girls love that shit because it's just an easy out for being fucking ugly that day.
Girlfriends love to tell you that you're dumb and you don't know anything and that the news is smart.
Yeah.
And that's the president. Why would he lie? How could he lie?
God saved me on that one for not having some fucking chick telling me about the, I mean, I don't want this to happen. It's like Jones saying, like, I don't want the lockdowns to happen.
Oh yeah. I want, you know, I want it to be, I want them to be like, damn, look at how dumb Jones is.
Yes.
I believe in this stuff. That's misinformation. There's no mask in the TSA.
I will be, it's the same shit about the kids in tunnels. I will be happy if I'm fucking wrong on this.
Oh yeah.
But dude, if they do this shit, it's just all out war. It's public freakouts every fucking. If it's just gonna be maybe you're out of your element.
Yeah, maybe
someone hits me with put your mask on, sir. I'm like, you're out of your element. Please do not talk to me. You have no frame of reference in this fucking conversation. You're out of your fucking element. Please shut the fuck up.
Yeah. No jurisdiction.
Shut the fuck up. I am a free citizen of the world, dude. Yeah. You're not gonna fuck with me.